Erica, good evening. What a day in central Indiana. Emotions high, raw emotions, tense moments here as this now investigation enters its eighth hour. They're still collecting evidence here at the middle school west. We also have seen search warrants being served. The other story, of course, is that of the teacher, the science teacher, Jason Siemens, who is being credited as being the hero here at Noblesville West. He is the man that students in the classroom tell me was able to swat the gun away from the gunman and tackle him to the ground until law enforcement could arrive. And during the time, one student, Ethan Stonebreaker, tells me that he saw his classmate walk into the classroom, pull out a gun out of his right pocket, and shooting into the classroom four to six times, and that is when Mr. Siemens was able to tackle him. Another student was shot. That student's name is not being released because we're waiting for police or the parents of that student to do so. But Ethan Stonebreaker, with his parents at his side, told me how he saw this all emerge just in real time. He is just sickened by what he saw, but he is so proud of what his teacher did in saving his life and the life of so many others in the classroom today. Here's what he had to tell RTV6.
Everyone was okay, and he was laying on top of the shooter, which was a student, making sure the gun was away from him, that he couldn't harm anyone else. And then we all just ran downstairs. Some of the sixth graders were at their locker currently when we got downstairs, and we like alerted them to what was going on, and they just looked really confused, like, this can't be real.
Is the shooter a seventh grader?
Yeah.
Did you know him?
He's in all my classes. He's in the same class. He's in Mr. Siemens' class and should have been taking the test, but was like a half hour late to class, and this has to be why.
Ethan, I hate to ask this question, but sometimes students will say, if I had to pick someone, that would have been the person. Is this odd? Is this strange? Is this out of the ordinary?
No, he never said anything like that. He really wasn't someone you'd suspect to do something like this. Like, he is a nice guy, but it's just the shock.
Real and shocking. In fact, Ethan will be appearing on Rural News tonight. We want to thank his parents for allowing us to talk to him this afternoon.